Hello everyone, today is about IP addressing. See, it is done on network layer. See, the main thing is IP address is divided into two types. One is classful IP address, and another is classless, that is CIDR, classless IP address. CIDR means classless inter-domain routing. I repeat, classless I for inter, D for domain, R for routing. So today we'll say about only classful IP address. For CIDR, I will make another video. Means in upcoming topics, I will make another video for CIDR. Now today we are interested only for classful IP addresses. See, classful IP address is again divided into five types. One is class A, then class B, and then is class C, then class D, and class E, These are the five types where classful IP address is divided. See, A, B, and C, only these three are used, and D and E are not used, they are reserved. This D and E are reserved. These are not used, reserved. Only A, B, and C are used. Now we'll see. Means in class A, network ID and host ID, and class A range, class B range, and class C range. See, class A range is from 0 to 127. See, in some book it is given 0 to 127, but it is not correct. The correct range is 1 to 126. This is the correct range, but in some books it is given. So then what about 0 and 127? So 0 and 127, it is for the means. See, it is for some subnetting and directed broadcasting address. So when I'll make, I means when I'm upcoming videos, and I'll teach you subnetting and directed broadcasting, means broadcasting, unicasting, some these are there. Then I'll tell you about 0 and 127. But now you remember, in class A, the range is 1 to 126. Now see, class A is divided into C, and the main thing is it is IP version 4. In IP, see, now you know that there are two types of means IP version 4 and IP version 6 is used. So it is IP version 4. I'm talking about IP version 4, and it is 32 bit. The main thing is 32 bit, and IP version 6 is 128 bit. IP version 4 is 32 bit, and IP version 6 is 128 bit. So see, it is 32 bit, so it contains 4 octet. See, it contains 4 octets. So here 8 bit, so how many? 32 bit total. So this 32 bit is divided into, see, one is net ID, one is host ID. So in class A, in this 32 bit is divided into, see, 8 bit of net and net ID, 8 bit of net ID, and 8 plus 24 is 32, so 24 bit of host ID. So what is this net ID and what is this host ID? See, from net ID we get means network of class A. How many networks are there in class A? And from host ID we get how many IP addresses are available. And from net ID we get how many networks are available in class A. So see, from 8 bit net ID, 1 bit is fixed. This is 0, 0, it is fixed. So we cannot use this. Why you cannot use this? I will tell you means in another video when I will teach you subnetting. Then BLSR. Then I will tell you about means fixed bit, why it is not used, and directed broadcasting addressing, limited broadcasting addressing. So there I will tell you. Now you understand about the one in 8 bit, 1 bit is fixed. Then how many bit are remaining? 7 bit are remaining. In 7 bit, how many combination of network can be formed? 2 to the power 7. How many? 2 to the power 7. There are 7 bit are remaining. Then how many combination of network can be formed? 2 to the power 7 is the maximum combination of network can be formed in class A. Then how many means IP address can be formed in class A? If they are 24 bit, you guess there is 2 to the power 24. So it's a huge 2 to the power 24 is a huge IP address you can get in from class A. Now we'll see, and mind its range is 1 to 126. Now we'll move to class B. See, on class B, the range is 128 to 191. This is the range. And here, NAT ID is 16-bit NAT ID. NAT ID is 16-bit and host ID is 24-bit. Host ID is 24-bit. See, here, see, in class 1 bit is fixed here. Now, here, 2 bit will be fixed. 1 and 0, these 2 bit are fixed. This 1 and 0, these 2 bits are fixed. And how many bits are remaining from 16-bit? 14 bits are remaining. Then how many network can be formed in class A? That is 2 to the power 14 network can be formed in class A. And how many host ID? See, another thing is, see, from NAT ID we get network, and from host ID, this is very, very important, from host ID we get IP addresses. So how many, this is 16-bit, sorry, this is 16-bit, 16 plus 16, 32. So how many host ID we get, means how many IP addresses we get? 2 to the power 16 IP addresses we get from class B. So this is about class B range and class B NAT ID and host ID. There are 14 network is available, and there are 2 to the power 16 IP addresses is available. There are 2 to the power 14, there is 2 to the power 16. Now we will move to class C. See, class C range is 192 to 223. This is the range of class C. So when some IP addresses will be given, means in your exam or in gate exam, and if the range starts from 192 to 223, then you understand it falls in class C range. Now see the how many host ID and NAT ID is there. See here, 24 NAT ID and yes, 8 host ID. So in 24 NAT ID, 3 bits are reserved here, means 3 bits are fixed. 3 bits are fixed, and what will be 3 bits are fixed, and how many bits are remaining? 21 bits are remaining. So here 2 to the power 21 network combination can be formed, and here 2 to the power 8, what will get? IP addresses. We'll get IP addresses in class C. 2 to the power 21 net means network can be formed in class C, and 2 to the power 8 IP addresses possible means in class C. Now this is about class C network ID and host ID. Now we will move to class D and class C. See, in the beginning, I have told you that class D and class C both are reserved, and we are using class A, class B, and class C. Now, class D and class C are not using, and in class D and class C, there are no NAT ID, there are no host ID. See, class D and class C, there are no NAT ID and no host ID, but there is a range. For theoretical concept, there means there for exam, there's a range is given. So class D range is starting from 224 to 239, and class E range starts from 240 to 255. This is the range of class E and this range of class D. See, in exam they will give you about the range only, means what is the range of class D and what is the range of class E, and nothing will be given you, because class D and class E are not used, they are reserved, they are used only for multicasting. And in the next video I'll teach you about multicasting, you will understand what is multicasting. But now remember that it is used only multicasting. Class D and class E is used for multicasting. So this is the what I have teach you here. This is enough for gate, because gate asks about only this question only, how many IP addresses can be formed, how many network can be formed, and nothing is asked. So it is okay here. So in the next video I'll move to casting, multicasting, broadcasting. Then I'll move to subnetting. Here we'll understand why 0 is not used and 127 we're not using in IP addresses. So thanks for watching. Thank you.